Thanks for joining us here on our Bob's Discount one-on-one. Excited to welcome in Eagle safety Will Parks. Will, thanks for joining us, man.
Yes, sir, man. How you doing?
Doing all right. So, look, a lot of Eagles fans are fully aware. You grew up in Philadelphia. You make that West Coast trip. You go out to school to Arizona, and then you go to the Denver Broncos. You come home here to Philly. I'm excited to dig into your athletic background. Before we get into football, what were some of the other sports that you played growing up, and what were like? What was your favorite sport, I guess, as a little kid?
My first official like organized sport was football. After that, I played basketball. I ran track. I played baseball up at the 21st Ward in Roxborough, and then I boxed a little bit. My uncle is George Benton, so I got a little bit of that boxing background.
Okay.
But I was pretty much all over. Like it was wherever it keep me out of trouble. That's wherever I was at playing sports.
Was there a sport that you feel best helped you make that transition to football, or do you kind of lean on most?
To be honest, like. I love football, like, it's in my heart, but, like, I'm not even going to lie. Like, I swear I was going to the NBA at one point in my career. I swear I was going to the NBA. I was like, man, I'm going to be just like AI. And I kind of made that football transition kind of 9th, 10th grade in high school. You know, it kind of was like, all right, look, you know, basketball is slim to none. Football is, like, a little bit higher than that. So I'm like, all right, yeah, I'm going to just stick with football. And it got me here.
How old were you when the Sixers went to the finals 0-1?
What I was six,
okay.
Seven, yes. No, I was 5-6. Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
So you were too young to like set up instead of. Were you awake?
I knew they played the Detroit Pistons
okay.
back then.
Okay. Like,
yeah.
I remember like vividly, you know, being up, you know, staying up for him doing the step over Tyronn Lue and everything, like all of that. I grew up in Philly, like not too far from where you grew up. So,
yes, sir.
You know, all that stuff, very, very reminiscent. I want to dig in now to your background playing football, because I know when you played at Germantown. You were a receiver in a corner, right?
Yes,
so
sir.
Did you always play the skill positions, even growing up through Pop Warner?
Yo, to believe it or not, my first official position in football was Jason Kelce. I was snapping the ball. I was a center, you know what I mean? And I was always aggressive. And then I transitioned to right guard when I went to the 75-pound, because I played for the Wissahickon Braves,
yep.
Little League team. I played right guard. And then I remember that same year, I was competing for a guy to play running back. He was like, hey, man, you fast. Running against this other fast guy with the ball in two hands and running the field. The guy just took off, and it beat me for the spot. But other than that, man, I kind of transitioned like quarterback. Then I played running back. Then I played corner, a little bit of linebacker. So I was really all over.
So Wissahickon Braves, is that the home field that's right by DeLisandro's?
Yes,
by
sir.
The
right, okay. right by DeLisandro's right. across from Chubby's. Yes,
all
sir.
Right. All right.
Yes,
just
sir.
Want to make sure that we're on the same page. All right, so. Were you excited about like making the switch out of skill position, or were you mad that you got moved from the offensive line?
I'm not even gonna lie, because when I was on the 75-pound football team, I played D tackle, and we played the Ben Salem Ramblers, and I had like 8 TFLs. I was just doing this nice old swim move the whole time. You know, kids don't know what a swim move is back then. I just seen it on Madden and just started taking off with it.
All right, so take us now. You get to high school and you're playing more wide receiver and corner. Then you go to Arizona. When did you make that transition to the safety spot? And I want to really dig into what that transition was like for you.
I'm going to be so detailed with this one.
All
so
right.
My first 2 weeks of training camp, I was at corner. I moved inside to nickel. Then I guess, you know, some way, somehow, they must have seen my aggressiveness and I could still cover inside. So it was like, hey, man, he's fast. He's whatever. He could do it all. Put him back high. I go back out of safety, and I'm messing up almost every play they call for me. I was just blitzing, and when it was a coverage, I was playing coverage when I was supposed to blitz. You know what I mean? So I kind of just had to relax a little bit, understand, you know, as a safety, you have to see everything. You know what I mean? Not just that corner vigil on one side of the field. You know, you have to be a quarterback back there. So after that, it kind of just was super easy once my coaching staff in Arizona was pretty legit. I'm not even going to lie. They're pretty legit. So they kept me up to par. And, you know, it got me here in the league.
Yeah, I feel like, you know, a lot of fans might look at a lot of corners and say, oh, well, you know, if he doesn't play well enough a corner, just move him to safety.
Oh, no.
There's so much that goes into that, right?
Yeah, they have no complete idea,
yeah.
You know, because at the end of the day, you know, we have to tackle.
Yep.
You know what I mean? So, I mean, if you're not ready to tackle, don't even think about coming back here.
Yeah, and you're seeing the field. Like, how difficult was it to see the field from, you know, 20 yards deep, 18 yards deep, as opposed to, you know, playing out on the boundary?
Oh, man, you know, it, at first, you know, when I first moved to safety in college, I would only visualize, you know, my side of the field. I seen my corner and I seen the backer in front of me in the D-tackle, so I kind of understood that part. But then he's like, no, you have to factor in the other side, too, because that might change your responsibility. I looked at him like, what? And after that, you know, I kind of just, you know, made that transition, and it became smooth. And, you know, they put a lot of emphasis on, you know, studying tape. And that's kind of one of my fortes, is studying tape and understanding what, you know, offensive schemes are trying to do, especially as a safety. When you get a beat like that, it makes your job a lot easier. You're a little bit closer to the ball. Instead of being 18 yards, you're now at, you know, 6 to 8 yards trying to make a tackle or play on the ball. So that's pretty good.
Who was a player when you first got to Denver, you first came into the NFL, that really kind of took you under the
wing? TJ Ward.
Really?
Okay. TJ Ward.
What did TJ do?
The first time I got drafted there, he said, "What's up to me?" May 6th was the official day I moved out to Denver from Philly after the draft. And he texted me on Twitter, like, "Hey, man, come to my crib at 8 o'clock. You know, I'm thinking, like, hey, you know, we're going to do something fun and stuff. Nah. Clean the crib, then we're going to do something fun. I had to clean his house. And then, you know, we went outside and stuff like that and had our fun. But it was kind of him, TJ Ward, Chris Harris, Aqib Talib, and Darian Stewart. You know, those were kind of the Fort Von Miller, DeMarcus Ware. You know, those six guys I kind of had as a young pup playing defense over there in Denver. That kind of put me under their wing and gave me the keys to the ropes.
And then lastly, one of the big things that was talked about when you came back to Philly was your versatility. So all the different things that you do at the safety spot, what's your favorite thing? Like, what's the thing that's like that gives you the most juice when the play is called?
To be honest, I mean, a lot of people know I love hitting and making tackles, but making plays on the ball. But one of my secret weapons, you know, I want to say, I'm gonna turn this to a different question. One of my secret weapons is putting a 300 pounder on their butt.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm kind of I get infatuated by that. I get a little feel off when I put a lineman on their butt.
Well, see, so like that goes back to you playing center. Like you're just trying to move people.
Yeah. I just want to I know if I hit a lineman. You know, now they know this little 200-pound guy isn't to be played with. Right. So now I kind of get away with a little bit more stuff, and I'm able to make more plays in the football. You know, when you're hitting those guys, you know, as a linebacker and stuff like that. So I'm 200 pounds. So if you catch me in the box, it's over for me. So I gotta hit you first.
Did you have a secret weapon as a boxer as a kid? Like, did you draw on that?
Yeah, I mean, like, my feet.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, my feet. You know, my feet. You know, and my uncle kind of was George Benton. He was a Philly shell guy, you know what I mean? So without the shoulder, with your shoulder, you need your feet, you know, to move and duck punches and stuff like that. So I kind of use that to my advantage as well.
Well, Will, this was awesome, man. Really appreciate you joining us here on our one-on-one presented by Bob's Discount Furniture. Stay safe. We'll talk to you soon, man.
Yes, sir, man. Appreciate you.